This video is a tutorial on the COCC schedule of classes. The class schedule is an interactive part of the COCC website and allows you to see when and where different classes are being offered all over COCC. The schedule is best used with the catalog and grad tracks after you have met with your academic advisor. The simplest way to reach the class schedule is from the Academics tab on the COCC homepage. However, you can also search for class schedule in the search bar at the top right. Here you can select your term, campuses and delivery methods, subject, and optionally include a specific course number. You can also search for classes that only meet on certain days or start at certain times. One of the most important aspects of picking a course is the course delivery method, so let's go over your options. Here at COCC, we offer 7 different course delivery methods to meet the needs and schedules of a wide variety of learners. The biggest difference in delivery method is whether the course is synchronous, meaning that you will attend class at a specific time with an instructor present, or asynchronous, meaning that you will not have to attend class at a specific time, but will instead be able to learn the material on your own schedule. Starting with our synchronous courses, the first option is in-person courses. For these classes, you will go to a specific location on one of the COCC campuses at a specific time. This is the traditional delivery method, where you'll be in a classroom with an instructor present. Some in-person classes are streamed, meaning that you will go to a campus and have a live video feed of an instructor on another campus, or you may be in the classroom with the instructor and have students from another campus also joining your class. A streaming class will always be described as such in the course description, so be sure to check those when you're registering for classes. Next, we have remote classes. Like in-person classes, you will attend class at a specific time, but you will do so remotely, using Zoom or some other video conferencing tool. Finally, in the synchronous category, we have remote/in-person classes. These classes will have specific times you must attend, but sometimes you will need to come to a specified location, and at other times, you can attend class remotely from your home. However, you must attend both the remote and in-person sessions. Next, let's look at our asynchronous offerings. The only fully asynchronous delivery method that COCC currently offers are our online classes. In these classes, you will receive course instruction virtually, usually through Canvas, with no requirement to attend class at a certain time. These types of classes are great for those with busy schedules who may need to do coursework outside of normal school hours. Online courses will still have deadlines to meet though, so make sure that you have enough room in your schedule before you take one of these kinds of courses. One important note about online courses is that online orientation is required prior to registering for an online course at COCC. Online orientation is a free course that you can access by clicking the link from any online course in the course schedule. Click the Enroll Now button on the page that appears to be enrolled in online orientation automatically. Last, let's take a look at our mixed delivery classes. These classes will have some elements of synchronous and some elements of asynchronous classes. First in this category are the in-person/online classes. These classes will have some class sessions at a specific place and time, with other instruction happening virtually, usually through Canvas. Similarly, remote/online classes will have some remote sessions, usually via Zoom, and some virtual instruction. And lastly, some courses that don't fit into any of these categories are given the designation of special, indicating that they mix two or more delivery methods in a unique way. These courses will always have information about where and when the course meets as part of their course information in the schedule of classes. Some of these courses, like this nursing course for example, will have some class activity on campus and some class activity elsewhere, so always be sure to check your course descriptions. Let's wrap this video up by talking about a few of the columns in the class schedule that we haven't discussed yet. First, we have the course name, and clicking on that course name will give you a brief description of the course, including how many credit hours it's worth. Next, we have the CRN, or the course reference number, the course title, including a course description, and the number of credits that the course is worth. Learning methods we've already discussed at length, but if you're ever unsure, you can always click on the method name and get a description of what that method will be. The campus code in the meeting days, times, and building column will let you know where and when your class is going to meet. Remember that some courses may meet in multiple places or times, or using different formats. So always check this description to make sure that you're in the right place at the right time. And remember that for courses that meet both remotely and in person, you'll need to attend both the remote and in-person sessions. In this example, the class will meet remotely via Zoom on Tuesdays at 10:30 a.m. and in the Health Career Center, room 140, on Thursdays, also at 10:30 a.m. You'll need to plan to attend both classes. The max seat, remaining seat, and waitlisting columns will let you know how many total seats are available in the course, how many are remaining, and how many are on the waitlist currently. We'll talk a little bit more about waitlisting in a minute. The instructors column will tell you who the instructor is, and if you click on their name, it will take you to their directory in the COCC system, where you can then email them if you have any questions about the course. If the course has any fees, those will be listed in the course schedule. And if the course requires a book, a link to purchase that book will also be in the class schedule. Returning to the subject of waitlists, if you are waitlisted for a course, don't panic. Before the term starts, you can register as usual and choose the option for waitlist. If a seat opens, you'll receive an email notification that the class has been added to your schedule. Be sure to have a plan B, though, as you are not necessarily guaranteed to get into a waitlisted course. After term starts, attend the course as if you were registered. Instructor approval will be required to add the course, and that will be given electronically. You can find more information about waitlisting on the COCC website. We hope that this video has been helpful as you plan out your time here at COCC. If you have any questions, our Admissions and Records Department is available by phone at 541-383-7500 or by email at welcome@cocc.edu. Thanks for watching, and we hope that you have a great learning experience here with us at COCC.